Good morning. Welcome to A Moment of Truth. I'm Stoney Kaiser, pastor of the Church of God of the Union Assembly here in Dalton, Georgia. What a great day it is in the Lord. I love my Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Lord of my life. I trust in Him. I believe in Him. I know that He has everything that I need. The Bible speaks in Peter's writing about He hath given unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness. And I am thankful today for my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ coming down here and dying on an old rugged cross in a world, a cold-hearted world, a world where people hated Him, they rejected Him, they didn't want to have what He had to say. The Bible says that He came to His own, and His own received Him not, but as many as did receive Him, to them gave He power to become the sons of God. So that is what I am happy today about, that I have received my Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior. And I want you to do the same thing, too. I want you to realize just how much the Lord does love you. When He came down here, He left a home in heaven for a specific reason, and that was to give you and I eternal life. And I am so thankful for that today. I want to get into another topic here this month. This message is going to be talking about the plan of God, what God intended from the very beginning of His way, how things changed with the human race from what man done, and how that he had upset God and to the point that God was even repented him, that He would even made man. How sad that it is that we, this God that made the universe and made the earth and made the human race and everything that we see, man displeased Him, and the sons of God displeased Him and caused what we have here today. So I want to get into this message. This is in Genesis, the 6th chapter, and we'll start reading at the 5th verse of Genesis. The book that Moses wrote us here, I'm glad to have all of this, speaking about the beginning. I like history myself. I'm not really a big history buff. I'm not real smart about all of natural history, but I do love the history of God and where man came from and how it all began, because that is how we can establish ourselves in faith. If we don't truly believe in God, and believe it or not, there's a lot of people out there that don't believe in God, period, let alone Jesus Christ as the Savior. They don't believe in God, period. And it's not understandable, is not the word that I'm looking for, but you can see where people would lose faith in knowing God is real by the things that they go through, because they haven't really understood God's purpose and His plan and why we are where we are at today. You see, in the very beginning of time, God didn't intend for man to have to till the ground. He didn't intend for man to have to work. The intentions for women to bear children in travail and pain, all of that come through the fall of Adam. It wasn't God's intention from the very beginning of His way. In the very beginning of His way, he had a garden here that the water come up and missed the garden, and man, it wasn't going to have to work for anything. But after Adam transgressed the laws of God, all of that changed, and the things that we go through in our life, it takes faith in Jesus Christ. It takes faith in God. He that cometh to God must believe, must believe. That verse, I love quoting that verse because it is what our whole life is really wrapped up in. He that cometh to God must believe. For you to get to God, you've got to believe. You've got to have faith. You've got to know that Jesus Christ is the Lord. That's the only way you can get to God. I've heard people on national television, way far beyond what my program gets to do or this program gets to do. I'm not about this me and my stuff. It's all about Jesus Christ. But what this program reaches out way beyond what we could ever do, people have gotten on national television and disclaimed the name of Jesus and saying that there's other ways to God than just through Jesus Christ. I deny that. God's Word denies it. Jesus said the only way that you can go to God is through Jesus Christ, and that's what we believe. But I want to get into this plan of God, and I'm going to read here from the book of Genesis, and we'll start at the 6th chapter and the 5th verse. This is the 6th chapter and the 5th verse. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Now, if you look at that and kind of compare that to today, where we are at today, God saw these things that was going on, and we'll get into them here in just a minute, what was actually happening. But he noticed that in the man's heart, all he wanted was evil. All he wanted to do was look at the evil things in life. And it displeased God. God wasn't happy with that. And if you look at the world today and the shape it's in, that's the way people are now. I don't believe that God is pleased with the majority of the people in this world. I do not believe that. I believe that he is not pleased with the majority of people in this world because they only look out for themselves. They only look out for their own wealth and gain. They don't have a heart or desire to help their fellow man. The majority of the people in the world, there's what I call religious war, what a lot of people call religious war, people that will kill in the name of religion, and it's not for Jesus Christ. It's for their own religion. And we'll get into that in this program about people that want to make a name for themselves. Well, these people here, God, in the beginning, the God up in the top of the first verse of that chapter, it talked about how that the second verse actually, how that the sons of God had saw the daughters of men, and I'm not really going to get into the different generations that was there, the two different generations that God had in the beginning of his time. We can, but what I want you to see is that God was not pleased with what was going on. These sons of God saw the daughters of men, and they started taking them for their own wives and bearing children to them. And these things didn't please God. It wasn't God's intentions from the very beginning. Now, I will say this, that from the very beginning of his way, even before his works of old, God chose us to sanctification through the Word. So God knew that in how the sovereignty of God, I guess is what I'm trying to say, we'll never understand all of that, at least not in this life. God said, my ways are not your ways, neither are my thoughts your thoughts. So for us to really try to understand everything about God, we never will. But to understand how his plan was for us, it's written in his book, and we can find that. So the mysteries of God, we get these and we understand them because God has revealed them to us by his Spirit. But in a natural thought, we can never grasp all of that. So we have to rely on God's Word and what he tells us to do. So God saw the wickedness of man, that it was great on the earth, and that every imagination of the thought was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. It grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. And this is where I want to take up this message. From the very beginning here, these people had turned their hearts from what God intended. And as we know, Adam transgressed the laws of God, and God had sent him out of the garden, and he drove out the devil out of the garden. But this Noah, he found favor in the eyes of the Lord. And if we look at what happened in the days of Noah, if we go to Matthew, the 24th chapter, and we'll start reading at the 35th verse, Jesus, these are the words of our Savior. He said, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. What's he speaking about? He's speaking about the day that he returns. See, in the beginning, when God sent the waters of the flood, he was disgusted with man and what man had done. and he destroyed the earth and all that was there, the men and the animals and all that didn't get on the ark, didn't get into this ark where Noah had found favor. Most everybody have heard the story of Noah and how that he had built this ark. God had told him to build the ark for the saving of his household. Well, that's the way, as if we look at the church today, that's the way that it is with us. In the beginning here, these men were not living according to God's will, and he was going to destroy the earth. But he found favor in Noah, and grace. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. God liked Noah. He knew that Noah lived and walked and talked with him, and he done true to God's will. That's the way God wants the church today. He wants us to live according to his will and to his plan and to follow what he had set in order. Well, when Jesus was speaking to these people in Matthew, you can see the resemblance of as it was in Noah's day, the way it is today. People are not living for God. They live for themselves. They want to build a name for themselves. They have all of this mighty power that they have. They build up themselves as though they are something. That's not God's will. If what we have, if God has given unto us anything, it ought to be for his glory and his honor. Not for ours, not to boast in ourselves, but to boast in God. I want to continue reading here in Matthew. The day and hour that he's speaking about is the day that Jesus Christ returns. Of that day and hour knoweth no man. What's he going to do when he returns? Jude tells us about it when he says when he comes with a destruction from the Almighty, he's going to come and bring destruction on those that know not God and obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. That gospel is to repent and turn from your sins. But here he said, as it was in the 38th verse, I'll read the 37th verse rather. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days of that were before the flood, they were eating, drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered in the ark, and knew not until the flood come and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. That's going to happen. There is going to come a day when God is going to destroy all the wicked off of this earth. When Adam transgressed the laws of God, God cursed the ground for Adam's sake and told him he'd have to till the ground from which he was taken. But there's coming a day we find in Revelations where he said he's going to take the curse off of the earth and the throne of God shall be in it. I'm excited about that. I'm excited about the day that all the troubles are passed away. As it was in the days of Noah, God destroyed the wicked. When Jesus comes back, he's going to destroy the wicked with the brightness of his coming. We love you today. Come down and visit us. We love talking about Jesus Christ. We're at 2211. South Dixie Highway here in Dalton, Georgia, the Church of God of the Union Assembly. May God bless you, is my prayer.